Welcome to the fall 2024 season of Titan. We're doing Divinity Night. It's the start of our doing Conduit Esports Revelation versus Sun Lara. And they both get hit by the knockup. We are watching the Tanguin gets pulled in by the Swingy, gets away with his flash in from the Diego. WN goes in onto the Gen and gets the first, getting the swallow onto the Viego. Viego going in again with a stun, but ends up getting killed by the Syndra. Tom catching the Kalanda, so Johnny, we do see Six coming in with him to teleport as well. Re-engage. Camille almost hitting Dorike with that, gets hit by the stun from Jax, does go down to Jax, Viego taking down this Sejuani, goes in with another reset, Viego does want to go on to this.
I mean, look at the mental games he's playing on them, glad I getting caught out though, wouldn't wait.
Viego, since Wayne's using his ghost, may have to use his flash as well, does get caught in by the comm. Tom, again, just tankier than ever, and then he's not dying. But Sir is once again going into this fight, CW coming in, kills almost getting killed by the Zay Bomb. And end up pulling them both, just again, tanking that damage, doesn't have to worry about anything, gets rooted again, gets pulled in, and that is a kill over to Ziggs. Sojuani going down to the Swain, and Jin trying to use it no follow-up. Vlada going in for the Ornn, but does end up getting taken down almost very quickly. The ultimate's coming in from both sides, unfortunately we do see the Fenn coming in. Sleep coming in for everybody, and that is going to be 3-for-1 so far. The Ash Hero was a little too soon after that. Right now, giving the Shockwave, though, gets both Terra damage out right now. He's just walking around. And he gets immediately lit up by the Lilia. Glada getting caught out. Doesn't flash away.
It's going to take a while. They're not going right back in, though.
Kills, getting killed by Fenbok. Ash about to go down. That is a triple kill. Fenbok coming in with a teleport. Does go straight into the fight. Trying to get everybody out. E coming in. Lilia gets blown up immediately. We do see Dory trying to run away. Ash gets stuck in the Camille ultimate. And that's going to be another
kill. Now Glada's still blood. They're still going to flash in the 3 members.
Glada grabs both.
It's going to be game 2 onto the side of Sir as they camp back from the
Formula are showing up. They want the fight. The Astro is not going to land. Alphine does not get the ground, but gets a 3-man Keeper's Verdict into the 3-man Shockwave. Lightning crashes, trying to go in. Contology does kite back. They drop the arrow. They're trying to burn through the Zeri, and they do. Winning Formula turn for the first kill, and with the health bar still healthy, they're going to push with the might.
That's besides the point.
Another missed arrow, but what an engage from Helper. Gets a 3-man Magnet Storm and just sends the Gwen to run wild. Melfi tries to kite back. Masuf is able to pull Zohair out of the fray, but it doesn't matter. There's a ton of damage, and Joby has to flash over while trying to get away from Helper. Now looks for the turn, but gets eviscerated. Charms down for Ibion Godly. It's just a complete melting pot, but who comes out on top? The girl with the scissors.
Does she have any dive potential unless quality player finds it?
Whoa, bot side. We're going for a dive, but Joby's here to try and clean up at least.
And now the minion takes the turret. Yep, that's it.
Alpha Day very low. Doesn't want to be the one to tank up. Does have the Rage Bar, but he doesn't get the Q off. He doesn't get Golden Meek in time. Masuf tries to flash to get rid of Zolair or smite it out of the Herald.
Masuf in a good spot.
Yep. This Aatrox is a powerful member here for IDF, but watch his health bar crumble as he eats a charm and a double stun to the face. And that is a Fed Renekton diving under the turret. I am play back in this one. One way could just be finding Zohair by himself. 1v4. They're going to go for the engage onto the Gwen. Lock her down. Try and burn through her. The Equalizer will get the job done, but look at the backside of this fight. It's just an Ashe and an Ahri running.
Definitely know how to side lane. Nice charm.
God, the fade away charm. Well, big heal though on the empowered auto attack. Quality player winning formula. Start right foot forward.
The wall of the condemned lands, and that's going to be Evil Zara. That's going to be stunned into the wall. Going to use the rocket jump forward, and they're next focusing your AI. Up the vein there. Hold on a second. Sailor hits a 2-person impale here. That is about as good as it gets. No dark shield that time for AI. No Zonias. So can't save yourself this time around in the same spot where the previous fight happened. Stun is going to go down here from Strength Growth using a teleport as well to try and save their AD carry, but that Morgana damage is going to be more than enough to bring that kill home. Depth Charge going to be used onto Stubby. Kimboy running around with the Spirit Rush. He's going to get himself a reset, but he's locked down by so much CC.
Move into the mid game with some heavy active items here as
Kimboy's been caught out. That's a Shockwave. That's an Impale. Back though, because they are very low, but there is a lot of red HP bars. Here's a big ult coming through from Kimboy, and AI's the target, but that was a huge Shockwave there from Sung Yuni. That might John up May, who's trying to put the DPS down to take out the jungler here from Omega Fever, and they're going to be successful in doing so. 850 gold will go the way of Strangle Root, and that Shockwave there from Sung Yuni was all that Syndicate Pepsi needed. That fourth item in for the ace will get the IE onto your Tristana, but May is feeling themselves. May is going crazy. The first kill, the second. Friends for the moment, but the Dredgeline will connect onto the Amumu. Look at the damage from the Tiger Stance. It's incredible. And the first blood will go to Kibaboy, and May
there's
with
no flash on Jinx.
going to use the barrier.
Then Amumu was a little bit late as
oh
the
my gosh. The bot lane to help out your Jinx super mega death rocket. The splash damage is good. The support duo here of Omega Fever. The curse of the sad mummy comes through. The dragon is exposed now for the rest of the fever, and they should be able to get this one, but it's an excellent shuffle now. One for one for the moment. Make that one for two. It concludes with an Omega Fever victory.
Right off the flash there onto the Viego, getting caught out potentially.
Last four
from Mark is into the bandage. Toss first blood going straight on over the move of the egg. That's gonna take away two. And okay. Now Kaz is next on the target list. Has to use the satchel. It's a great knockup against Stun into the tremendous great shield. Marking it, but that bandage toss hit a minion. And it's a nice great fate shield into the shot. They get out of Kaz gets engaged upon that Amumu. They want to be able to burst it down now. Jordan bot might be extremely weak.
Big shockwave.
The fate shield into the shockwave. Is able to help find two. So it's a two for one. Visit of Empire. It's just play. Already over to side now to Mark as Troy goes in with a flash, gets stunned up himself from the brand, goes on to Jamar because he can't flash. I don't think PDG's gonna let them. Brandy fan pushing up forward the W side through the wall. The warp, two man line. Go suppressed though, a little bit too late. Unstoppable force is gonna be able to help find that execution as Troy's gonna be able to flash. Dominance, able to find one, has to return and retreat. Somebody has got to peel for Brandy fan. The flash forward gets the shutdown of the mob line, but they're gonna be able to trade that out. 2-4-2 at the moment. Make oh, you don't want to go there. The stun, he's gonna be able to assassinate the Nami. It's a two-man drowsy this time around, but is it gonna be enough to be able to save himself? No, it will not. Flashing on forward with the ultimate will be Vision of Empire. Is able to find Noosh. Okay, that's 2-4-1 trade-off at the moment. Can they continue to pummel this one on in? Brainy Fan has got to contest this entire fight. The fourth shot isn't enough damage. Yes, it's gonna be a double kill for Vision.